I'm taking the four horsemen, and I'm taking the NWO, and I'm putting them in.
Oh. Gotta be kidding me. Oh. Bombshell.
We're gonna find out at the end of that match who bellies up to the bar or who just bellies up. Good night, says the chairman.
The chairman has spoken. Good afternoon, everyone. This is a special edition of WCW Pro. I'm Scott Hudson. He's the living legend, Larry Zbysko. And legend, we just saw Roddy Piper make it crystal clear who's going to enter the rage in the tomorrow night.
I know. It's almost like a special bulletin blurped across a special edition show. Now we have a wartime consigliere in World Championship Wrestling. Piper, he's a man that can hammer down nails in the coffin of the New World Order.
It's the New World Order versus the Four Horsemen tomorrow night at Fall Brawl. And as we heard this morning on the main event, two new big matches added to that stellar lineup. Diamond Dallas Page and Lex Luger face Randy Savage and Scott Hall. Also, the big man, the giant, in there against Scott Norton. Tomorrow night, Fall Brawl is going to be hot.
Fall Brawl is going to be not only hot, Scott, it's going to be the end of the New World Order as you people know it.
Legend, it could very well be the end of the New World Order tomorrow night at Fall Brawl, but when you put eight men that hate each other that bad inside a cage, this isn't going to be a wrestling match. I hope no amateur wrestlers watch this going to pick up some points to win a Greco-Roman contest. This is going to be an all-out war.
Well, the emotion and the hatred is on the side of the Four Horsemen. In the New World Order, I don't think they hate the Four Horsemen. They tried to ridicule them. They had a stupid parody and tried to insult them. And all they did was something one of my old martial arts teachers used to teach me. And one of his favorite sayings was, never wake the sleeping tiger. Not only have the New World Order goofballs woken the sleeping tiger, they're jumping right into his own cage.
It is going to be something else tomorrow night at Fall Brawl. Dave Sierra and La Parca starting things off on this special Saturday edition of WCW Pro. Just finished a good lunch, legend. Hope I can make it through this match. Like,
well, you certainly don't need dinner.
Well, good point. Collar and elbow tie-up, La Parca and Dave Sierra. You know, we heard this morning on WCW main event, two new matches announced. We have got Lex Luger and Diamond Dallas Page. They're going to take on Scott Hall and Randy Savage of the New World Order. That match came about as a result of what happened last Monday Nitro. We'll see that footage later on in the Pro, but you could just as easily put those four guys in the cage too in the War Games.
Yeah, let me tell you something again. I think another plan of the New World Order that's going to backfire and hit them in the face, just like La Parca did right here. Lex Luger, Diamond Dallas Page, had a brief falling out, a little misunderstanding, but I think they both came to their senses and they both realized that it was nothing but a plot by the New World Order trying to make a chess move, but it's only going to lead to a checkmate now. Not only do the Four Horsemen have a common denominator against the New World Order, but Lex Luger and Diamond Dallas Page have the same adrenaline rush, have the same common denominator, and they will be a force united as one against Hall and against Savage.
That's all coming up tomorrow night at Fall Brawl. La Parca hits a dropkick on the masked Dave Sierra. Oh, the right forearm across the upper back.
Why is Dave Sierra masked?
I don't know.
Is he trying like for luchador school or something?
Luchador school? I have no idea. You'll have to ask him.
I don't talk Spanish.
You know what? Let me get your opinion, legend. You were there at Nitro last Monday night. What about this ridiculous stunt pulled by Hollywood Hulk Hogan and the rest of the New World Disorder, Eric Bischoff and the like, when it looked for all the world like, oh, Sonny Onoo put in some nice kicks on Dave Sierra, took him down. Looked for all the world like Sting had fallen to some serious injury at ringside when he was making what it wasn't his entrance on Nitro.
Well, you know, I think that was something Hollywood Hulk Hogan came up, because we all know that he is avoiding Sting. Sting is a man he does not want to get in the ring with, and Sting kept dropping down, interfering with the New World Order plans. I think that's what Hollywood Hogan would like to see happen. He would like to see Sting fall down and hurt himself in his career, or possibly worse. So I think he threw it out there as a psychological game plan, you know, trying to instill that another mockery. They mocked the Four Horsemen, they mocked Diamond Dallas Page and Luger, and now they're trying to mock Sting. But mocking somebody won't matter. Physically, they can't beat them. That's why they're trying to make fun of them.
I think secretly that Hogan fears Sting. I think somewhere in there, in that display we saw last Monday night with the mannequin and everything, I think Hogan fears Sting, and I think when Rowdy Roddy Piper, the new chairman of the executive committee of WCW, puts that match together, which he said he will do before the end of 1997, when it's Hogan and Sting, Hogan will have to face his fear.
Tell you that, soon as Roddy Piper does that, you're going to see Hogan throw himself off the ceiling.
Maybe. We'll see that footage from the chairman, Roddy Piper, later in this edition of The Pro. Right now, La Parca going up top, twisting body press, caught him with the legs, now hooks the leg and hooks the arm, gets the pinfall. Nice victory for La Parca to start things off on a Saturday edition of The Pro. Sonny Onoo, a very happy camper. Stay with us.